a multi-room sound system that has little to envy to famous products like the ones from Sonos, built with one Raspberry Pi and a bunch of old Android devices. Let's see how to get there. For this project, we need a central music server. I will use a Raspberry Pi 3. It is a good candidate because it's quite cheap, about 30 or 34 euros from the official online store. It has low power requirements, so we can think to leave it running 24 hours a day. And it is officially supported by Volumio. That is the software we are going to use to feed the music on our clients. Volumio is a complete and ready-to-use system to transform a computer into a networked jukebox. The Raspberry version is based on Raspbian, the main and official Linux distribution, directly supported by the Raspbian Foundation. We have just to download it on our PC and then to flash it on a micro SD card. When the download is over, we extract the archive on our desktop, and then we can also delete the original zip, keeping only the extracted folder. Now we can insert the micro SD card in our computer, maybe using an USB adapter. Keep an eye on the drive letter that is assigned to the card, if you are using Windows, of course. In our case, it's D. This is very important, especially if you have more drives in your computer, because we are going to wipe the contents of the SD card, and we don't want to do this on the wrong drive. Flashing can be done with a variety of different applications. Today I will use Win32 Disk Imager, but you can do the same thing with the Rufus or with Etcher. That is available also for Mac OS and for Linux. The procedure is very similar. Open Win32 Disk Imager and select the Volumio image file. Then select the SD card unit from the drop-down on the right. In our case, our D drive is already selected because it's the only flash drive currently attached to this computer. Finally, click on Write. The application asks us a confirmation before proceeding with the flash procedure. Again, double check that you are going to write to the right unit. When the write process is over, you'll see a few errors on the screen. This is normal because Windows doesn't know what to do with the Linux partitions that are now on the SD card. Dismiss all of them and don't answer yes to the request to format the drive if you don't want to erase what you just done. Finally, we can unmount the card from our computer. Now we can insert the card into our Raspberry and give it power with a standard micro USB cable and a standard power supply like the one for smartphone. After some minutes, try to scan the available Wi-Fi networks. A new access point named Volumio should appear. Select it and enter as password Volumio 2. Now my computer is not asking me because I already saved it in the past. When connected, go with your browser to the address Volumio without any extension. The Volumio initial wizard should appear. It will prompt you to know your preferred language. Then the network name of the Volumio device that we can leave untouched. The main audio output that we can leave set on the standard earphone jack of the Raspberry Pi. And then here we have to select our own Wi-Fi to bring it inside the normal connectivity. Just select your Wi-Fi and enter your password. In the screen, we can add one or more disk units to add our personal music. We will leave it empty for the moment. Okay, the wizard is completed and we can get into the Volumio user interface. When we try any options, we will have to wait a few seconds because the network configuration is updating and connecting to our private Wi-Fi. We didn't add any local music, so we will play a web radio from the huge selection available in Volumio. If you plug it in a speaker or an earphone to the jack of the Raspberry, now you should hear the music playing. Now that we have our Volumio box, we proceed to transform it into a broadcast music hub to connect more networked devices. To accomplish this task, we'll use the Volumio Snapcast plugin that you can find on GitHub. Snapcast is a music server that is able to keep its client in sync. This plugin connects Snapcast to Volumio, bringing its output to your local network. Unfortunately, this is not an official Volumio extension, so we have to install it with a Linux terminal. The first step is to enable the Ssh Access to Volumio. To do this, we have to go to volumio/dev with our browser. Here we have a, let's say, a hidden screen where we have just to click on the Enable button to switch Ssh on. Then we need another free application named Patty. This is an Ssh client that is very famous for people that work with Windows workstations, but with the need to remotely access Linux servers. Volumio is based on Linux, so Patty is here to help us. Type the Volumio address in the hostname field and then click on Open. Now type Volumio as username and also for the password. You will see that no asterisks are shown in the password, but don't worry, just type Volumio and press Enter on the keyboard. A nice ASCII art welcomes us, and the prompt is waiting to receive commands. The first command we have to type is wget, followed by the address of the zip archive of the Snapcast plugin that we can copy from GitHub. Copy it and then paste on the terminal window, simply clicking on it with the right mouse button. Then press Enter. In a few seconds, the zip file will be downloaded into the Volumio box. The second command is to extract the archive we have just downloaded. Volumio does not include an unzip command, but we can install it now. First, we have to update the list of the available software with the sudo apt get update. We wait while it downloads the installable software from the repository of Volumio. And finally, we type sudo apt install unzip. It asks us to enter the same password again, and unzip will be installed. Now we can extract the archive with a simple unzip master.zip. It will take just some seconds. When the extraction is completed, we type ls followed by enter. We can see the original zip file on the left and the folder with the extracted files on the right. We can delete the zip with rm master.zip, just to keep it clean. Finally, we enter the extracted directory with cd followed by its name. You can also type the beginning of its name and then press the tab button on the keyboard to have it auto-completed. With another ls, we can see the contents of this folder. To install the plugin, it's better to follow the instructions on GitHub that suggests to remove a zip file that we see here. So, like before, we type rm followed by the name of this file. And now, the installation of the plugin. With Volumio, plugin, install. This process will take some minutes, so we have just a way to finish. The activities with SSH are completed, so we can disconnect with a surprising exit followed by enter. We come back to the web interface just to enter the settings menu and select the plugin section. In the installed plugins tab, we find the Snapcast server that we have just installed. Let's switch it on and take a look to its settings. Here there are many options, but we have not much to do. The defaults are fine. We have only to press on the patch file button under the else section. And when we come back to the installed plugin screen, we should find Snapcast switched on. Our broadcasting machine is ready. The last task is to install the Snapcast app on the Android devices we want to use as client. You can find it on the Play Store and it's free. The configuration is trivial. Just start it and go to the settings, then enter your Volumio box hostname and finally tap the play button. Here we have the Volumio box ready to rock. I connected an USB key with some licensed music for our tests. These are my mixed Android devices. And this is the Volumio web interface. Let's start playing. The music is now coming from the speakers directly connected to the Raspberry Pi. Now let's connect this Xiaomi mobile phone. Then this mini Wiko. As you can see, the sync is not perfect, but it will go better after some time after all the clients will be connected. The third device is this Chinese Doji Mix. Okay, it's too Chinese, so it's stuck. Let's see later. This is my no-brand tablet. And back to the Doji. All together along the Volumio box itself. We can also adjust the volume of each individual device from each screen. They immediately share the same settings. The quality here is terrible, but only because we are listening from the integrated loudspeakers. Connecting some boombox or a better amplifier will bring a good sound, even with cheap smartphones or tablets like this.
And when we say synchronized music, we have it here. So we have this weekend displaying the song, but if we move to the second room, we have this Doji mix displaying the same song in sync with the first one, but also the Raspberry, our music server, the displaying directly connected to the speakers. And in the third room we have also this Xiaomi, again in sync with the others one. So we have the same music perfectly in sync in the three rooms of our office, connected on the same Wi-Fi. So that's all. Thank you for watching this tutorial, and see you soon.